Now, many people who've been adopted will never know their birth parents, while others spend years searching.
One Kiwi adoptee decided he wanted to find his biological family, and he did. Now he's helping others do the same.
Alex Gilbert is a Kiwi who was born in Russia and then adopted by a New Zealand family when he was just two. When he was in his 20s, Alex started his journey to find his biological family. And after a life-changing reunion, he decided to help other adopted children do the same. It's a journey that's taken him across the world, and now he's able to share those stories in a new TV series.
And Alex is here now. Lovely to see you, Alex. How many families did you reunite for this program?
Six beautiful families. Just amazing, amazing families, and very happy I helped. Very happy I helped them.
And was there one story that particularly stood out to you?
A girl, Victoria, she's from Gore, and she's actually from the same area where I was from in Russia. And it's such a beautiful, beautiful start to the series, a lot of up and downs, but it just really stood out to me personally.
Tell us about how it feels to find birth parents who are such a long way from New Zealand. Because I imagine the feeling of emotion is huge even when they're in New Zealand, but when it's so far away, it's just so much more complicated.
It's very emotional, of course, for both sides of the families. I always put myself in the shoes of both sides, birth parents and the adoptee. And when you see a connection with somebody over in a country like Russia, so far away, the people, the birth families then have to understand where New Zealand is and connect with that. And it's very emotional for both ends because you're also looking after the adoptee, but also we're also speaking with the birth families.
And what are the first steps for someone wanting to locate and connect with their biological family?
It's a good question because there's no right answer. A lot of people connecting with birth family, a lot of the searches that I've done myself for other adoptees is all through social media. So that has been the luck of the draw with that as well. But of course, not every story is the same. So there could be no information, there could be something there, or it could take a very long time. But I always say to every adoptee, you know, just keep giving yourself some hope and talk to somebody close to you that can support you along the way, because you don't know how long it's going to take.
Is there any support or resources out there for people who are adopted and wanting to find their families?
For resources, we have the I'm Adopted organisation that I've founded. We help with support to adoptees each other. It doesn't necessarily help with searches. That's something that I've been doing through my own experience for the show. But with I'm Adopted, we have that support network for adoptees to connect with each other.
Alex, it's such an interesting area, and I imagine there have been some massive changes to adoption over the years.
Yeah, so adoption between Russia and New Zealand was cut off in 2013, but before that we have over 700 Russian adoptees here in New Zealand. So we do have a lot of adoptees here that I have connected with, and when it comes to connecting with Russia, so many of them have so many different views on it, like the culture, the language, all of that stuff. And for myself, I just find it so special. As well as New Zealand being my home, Russia is my blood and my background, so that's how I connect with both sides.
Thanks so much for coming on the show tonight, Alex. Great to talk to you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it. Thank you.